Hello, my name is Eric Nunez, and the masterpiece I'll be doing today is The Indian Hunter at Sunset by Henry Rothschild. It is a 2D oil painting on canvas over desert terrain, much like the one we live in here in El Paso, except we don't have an amazing river like this one, which leads me to my next point, which is the first element line. And the river shows a horizontal line, which means that there's calmness and peacefulness here, which is a shape. This painting has tons of organic shape, as you can see the mountains right here curving, giving the more rugged, rough feel, far more naturalistic look. But also there's points where, like right here, there's a square top, or the circle of the sun, which can be organic, or it can be geometric, depending on how the artist uses it. Here, I believe Henry Rothschild uses it as organic to give it more of the naturalistic feel. As you can see, the light reflects off the water coming from the sun, drawing your focal point and your emphasis right here on the main point where also what the Indian is looking towards. As you can see, the sun is setting, so the sky's turning reddish, orange, and yellow at the top, which also leads to my next point, which is color. Orange is the color for hunger. And obviously the Indian hunter is hunting. That's why he's gazing off looking for his prey. So he's obviously hungry. And then he gives you warm colors. Like orange is a warm color. I believe there's low key because it's light colors up here. But there's also high key, such as like right here. The chiaroscuro, the gradations between light and dark and all that. The palette is mainly like monochromatic because it's all different tints of red and different colors of different tints of red, because it goes from orange and yellow, but there's also some brown and some green, but it's mainly monochromatic or its texture. And as I said, the mountains look pretty rough and pretty rugged. Like, this is back then when there was no cities or anything like that, so they lived off what they had, and what they had was the mountains, and that's pretty rough. But you can see the water, it looks very calm and peaceful, like if you just want to dive in and take a swim, like, and relax. But that also leads me to my next point, the space, which gives the atmospheric perspective. Like, the mountains look really small from far away, but you know they're really big, like if you come up too close to it, that's why they look smaller than these up here in the foreground. But because of atmospheric perspective that the artist uses, the mountains are smaller, farther away. Time, as you can tell, the sun is setting, so you know it's like late in the afternoon. The Indian hunter is trying to get some dinner. But he's really focused in trying to get his dinner, so that leads me to my next element, which is movement. He's too focused to be moving, but the only movement you can really see actually is the water, kind of like calmly moving with the ripples. And now I'll be moving on to the principles of design. I believe there's unity, as you can tell, the mountains all kind of look alike, but they're different peaks though. But it forms the unity in the sense that there's mountains like on throughout the whole painting. That moves me to my next point, which is the symmetrical balance. I believe this one has symmetrical balance because there's 1, 2, 3 peaks on the side. There's also the focal point. As you can see, your eyes are drawn towards right here in the center where the sun is shining light off the river. Also, you can see the directional forces that the Indian hunter has as he's facing this way and his eyes are pointed this way, so it draws your eyes towards the center to this one point. As you can see, everything comes from this one point. Everything originates from one point right there. Which leads me to my next point, which is scale and proportion. I believe this scale here, like, you know the mountains are big, but you know that they're not so big that it makes the man look so tiny. Like, he looks like a normal man you would see if you went hiking, like at, say, Waco Tanks. Like, that's how small they look compared to the mountains like these. So we know it's in scale and it's not like out of hand. And I hope you really enjoyed this presentation. I hope you really get the chance to come out here to visit the El Paso Museum of Art and witness this painting and see how much it has touched me, and hopefully it touches you just the same way.